Today I want to go over how I shoot and retouch these types of photographs, and basically this was shot during the blue hour. Now typically the blue hour happens about an hour and 15 minutes before sunrise. It's a slight little tint of blue that just starts to come across the sky. And these are some of my favorite types of photographs to shoot. They're some of the most difficult to shoot at the same time, but I'm going to go over some of the little settings I use and the tips and tricks on how I go about retouching this. So first off, this was shot in Ski Town in Colorado. It was about negative 20 below zero Fahrenheit, which is about negative 29 Celsius. Super cold, dressed up in triple layers. I headed out onto the site, parked my truck, grabbed the tripod and my camera equipment, and I set up on this deck overlooking the ski village here. So one thing I do like about shooting at the blue hour, especially early in the morning, is there's very little cars going by and there's nobody out walking around. Especially when it's negative 20 Fahrenheit, nobody in their right mind would be walking around on this kind of a morning. But at the same time, when it is this cold, it creates some of the most beautiful photographs. So I knew a storm came through. It cleared out probably around 1-2 o'clock in the morning. And there was still just a little bit of clouds just kind of hanging over the peaks over here. So once I got my camera set up on my tripod, I set my timer for 5 seconds. And my idea was I wanted to be able to hit the trigger, the camera not to shake, and then snap the picture. I try to avoid having to use a remote on these types of temperatures, because the problem is just one more thing to have to deal with. And with that cold, I have big thick mittens on and it's really hard to control the remote sometimes that way. So the next thing I wanted to do is I wanted to make sure I kind of focused in on these buildings. Since we did have a lot of light going on with the buildings, I was able to take my kit lens that came with the camera and I pretty much cropped the shot I wanted to do, went ahead and hit the button about halfway down to where it would auto focus. Once I knew I had the focus in, I would stick it in manual. This is extremely important. Okay, so I want to show you the settings I use. Let me go ahead and pull that up for you. So after doing a couple practice shots, I finally settled on this setting. The trick was is try not to blow out the buildings, but yet still be able to capture the blue hour, kind of lighten up the mountains in the backdrop. I ended up doing 1.6 seconds. My aperture was at 7.1. And for those of you that watched my last video, I talked about not to go below that 7.1 aperture when you're shooting these types of shots here. Because once you do go below that 7.1 aperture, you're going to start getting a real soft look on your pictures. It just won't be near as sharp. And then I settled on ISO 400. So 400 was just enough to light up the buildings, but not to blow out the lights too much. But I was still able to capture the blue sky here. And I had my kit lens, the 18-55mm. And once again, I zoomed in to where I want the shot, kind of hit that button halfway down, got it in focus, and then put it in the manual. Okay, now that I just showed you the settings, I want to do is show you the before and after for retouching this. And this is actually going to be some advanced editing in Lightroom, but I'll try to go nice and slow, and you can always pause the video and rewind if you have any questions there. So the before, you could see it's real flat, kind of dull looking here, where the after, I was able to bring out the buildings and just make them pop. One important thing to do when you're shooting these types of photographs is make sure you're shooting in RAW format. Critical part about shooting in RAW is when we're doing the retouch at this point. When you shoot in JPEG, you just don't get near as much information saved into the file. Okay, so let's go ahead and I'm going to show you how I went about retouching this photograph. So let me go ahead and hit reset. All right, the very first thing I want to do is I'm going to kind of bring out the sky right here. So I'm going to go to my graduated filter, click on that. I'm going to make sure my exposure is bumped up a little bit here. And I'm going to drag this filter down on top here, grab the center, and I'm going to move it down just a little bit more. Go back over to exposure. Let me just kind of crank it up a little higher. Let me bring that down just a hair more there. And then once I feel pretty good about that, I'm going to hit done. Once again, I'm going to do one more graduated filter. And this time I want to go from the bottom up. So let me drag this one up. I'm going to bring this just kind of above the buildings. And then I want to do is I'm going to take my highlights way down on this one and then take my shadows way up. And I'll go ahead and I'll adjust this to right where I think it looks pretty good. I'm going to bump my whites up just a little bit and then take the blacks down just a little bit on this one here. I'm going to hit done. So there's a couple issues I do see on this photograph, and let me zoom in. I do have some lens flare going on, so I want to go ahead and fix this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here to the spot removal tool, click on that once. I'm going to come over the spot right here that I want to fix. This is one of the lens flares. I'm going to kind of center up, and I can scroll my wheel on my mouse to make it bigger or smaller here. I'm going to click once. Now, what it's going to do is try to find something that's kind of pretty close to the same lighting and everything here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually click this, and I do want to adjust this a little bit better. I'm actually dragging this over. And I'm going to bring it up just a hair. And I'm just trying to line this building up just a little bit here. Once I feel good with that, I'm just going to hit done. Now I do have a couple other lens flares I want to fix. I have about three little spots right here. So once again, I'll hit the spot removal tool. Scroll to the right size. I'm going to click on that once. Hit my enter key. Go to the next one. Hit enter and then scroll to the next one here. And then I do see one more real small one. So I'm going to scroll my wheel down here, click it once and hit enter. Once I feel good about all those, I'll hit done. Let me zoom back out. Okay, the next thing I want to do is I kind of want to crop this picture a little bit. I do have a lot of empty sky up here. I do have a cool effect with the smoke coming up or the steam from the building here. So what I want to do is come over here to the crop tool, click that once, and I'm going to come up on top and I'm going to just drag this down just a little bit and then I'll hit enter. Okay, now I want to do is I'm actually going to come down the right side here and do a couple touch-ups here. So I'm actually going to take the highlights down even a little bit more here. Take the shadows up just a bump. I'm going to come on down and I want to do some of the saturations here. So under the HSL color black and white, let's go ahead and just adjust some of the saturation on the different colors here. And as I'm going along here, I'm always looking at the photograph, trying to check the colors and make sure they look good as I'm going along. And some of these I'll bring up, some I'll bring down a little bit. It just depends on the lighting you have in your photograph. Under detail, I like to sharpen these buildings up quite a bit. So I'm actually going to take these up all the way up to about 75, 76. And then I'm going to do is hold my option key down on my Mac, which is your alt key on Windows. And I'm going to grab the masking tool and I'm going to pull it to the right. And I want to blacken all the areas that won't get sharpened. And all the white will be getting sharpened. Now under noise reduction, if you do have some noise, and your noise basically is that real light grain that's in your photographs. And I can always do is I'll kind of go ahead and zoom in a little bit. And there's a bit of noise up in this area. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to noise reduction. I'm going to click on this and I'm just slowly bringing it to the right, just looking for that grain to disappear. Definitely be careful with this, not to go too far. Your shots will look really pasty. So you have to find that fine balance between it all. I'm going to stick with 55 on this one. Next, let's come down to the lens correction tab here. And you can always just click on these little arrows right here to get down to it. And I want to do is enable profile correction. Now, if you click enable profile correction and you have none, what you want to do is go ahead and find your lens. So I'm going to go under Nikon. And a lot of times it'll automatically find your lens at that point. Next, under transform, let's come down here. And I want to do is try to level this shot out just a little bit better. It was so cold out there, I had a hard time just getting my camera dead set level, but I knew I can always fix it in Lightroom. So I'm just going to go under auto. And to show you real quick the difference, here's before and there's after. Under highlight priority in the effects tab here, I always like to take these kind of winter shots, especially these early morning or late evenings. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to bump this up a little bit. And what I'm doing is I'm creating this really soft light edge kind of going around the shot here. And last but least, I want to go to dehaze and just bring it up probably to about 5. Okay, the last thing I want to do is I want to make these buildings pop a little bit better. So my favorite filter to use is to come up here to the top, and I love this radial filter right here. So I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to adjust my exposure to about 47. Now I'm going to go around and I'm just going to make some little circles here. And I can always adjust the brightness on these. And the idea here is you just want to make your buildings just pop just a little bit. And I'm just going to go real fast here just to give you kind of an idea. A lot of times I'll spend, this is where I do spend a lot of time touching up my photographs, is I'll go into great detail with this radial filter here and just lighten up certain areas. And I love the snowy buildings here because this is where the radial filter makes these buildings pop that much better. So as we go along here, let me just kind of light these up a little bit. And I could always come over and self-adjust. And if you ever want to go back to one, you just kind of hover over and you should see all your little dots. You could just click on one dot and then you can adjust the exposure on that particular filter. And then down here, I'll just add a little one down here by the street. Put another one about right here. And let's just do a really big one where I just go over the buildings. Now this big one here, I'll just kind of adjust the exposure just a hair. But I want to do is bring the clarity up just a little bit more, just to make them pop that much better. Then I'll hit done. Then the very last thing I always like to do is right here, clarity, vibrance, and saturation. I'll adjust these, but I think this one I'll just bump up the vibrance just a little bit more and the saturation. Okay, that's how you go ahead and shoot and retouch these types of photographs. These are difficult to take. They take a lot of endurance just to deal with the temperatures or the type of weather, but they are also the most rewarding type of photographs. I think these are probably my top selling types of photographs are these right here, because it's something that most people don't do out there. And there's a reason for that. Most people don't want to be getting up at 5 a.m. and jumping out in the bitter cold. So anyways, I hope this video helped you out. If it did, hit that like button down below. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed, and we'll catch you guys on the next video.